If the West Wing is the administration's hyper-caffeinated nerve center.
Hello.
Okay. Office of the President.
The grand stage, then, is the White House itself. It's been home to every president since John Adams, and also a place where presidents can choreograph events that set the nation's agenda, or at least try to.
This is your house, I'm a guest.
Oh, well, it's the people's house.
Admiral Stephen Rochon, a proud product of New Orleans, holds the position of chief usher at the White House. That means he runs this structure. He's only the eighth man to hold that title, and like his boss, he's the first African-American in the job in this house, built in part by slaves.
Folks really understand how much we need that 45 minutes.
The Admiral has a huge job. In effect, he's running an American museum, a bustling office space, and a private home. Today, that means prepping the East Room for an appearance by the President.
Is Dennis briefing the President before?
As with every event, it means invitations have been sent out, background checks have been performed, and seating charts have been drawn up. And it's just one event today. The President's topic today, cybersecurity.
I gave everybody your edits. Do you still need to go through it? Or
The edits should be...
Ask him to think it was good enough just with the edits.
Yeah, I don't think I have to actually talk to anybody about it.
Okay.
All right.
Soon, top national security officials sweep into the White House. The White House press corps takes up its position. Behind every event like this, you'll find any number of worried young staffers.
What's the deal with the cyber deal?
Today, it's Assistant Press Secretary Nick Shapiro and Deputy Press Secretary Bill Burton anticipating reporter questions over the president's new plan for a cyber security chief.
In the campaign, he said, this person will report directly to me. In the speech, he's saying, this person will report to the NSC and the NEC.
It's the kind of inconsistency White House reporters can feast on.
No, it's also an economic issue.
That's why sure enough, even before the president speaks, Shapiro finds himself being grilled by our own Chuck Todd.
This office is in the new National Security Integrated Staff that reports to both NEC and NSC.
So it is
because it's an economic.
You cannot not call this a czar.
The cybersecurity event starts at 11:08 a.m.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
The East Room setting lending substance to a plan that's still not completely formed.
I'm creating a new office here at the White House that will be led by the cybersecurity coordinator.
Press Secretary Robert Gibbs knows what a powerful stage the White House can be and admits to being a little awed by it himself.
You work hard for a living, but do you have these moments where you're thinking, Lincoln's casket was in this room, here's President Kennedy's portrait?
Sure. I was looking at the Kennedy portrait just a few minutes ago. You're hard-pressed not to understand it every time you walk. I mean, you walk along the colonnade at the end of the day, and it's a little warm, and it's just a beautiful night. You realize I'm walking by the Rose Garden. It's a special place to work.
The president's second event of the day is across town. That means a full motorcade, Secret Service, and D.C. police. Days of advanced planning, and it means traveling media, because there are way too many reporters to go on every outing. Each day, a small so-called press pool travels with the president. They report back on the outing to all of their colleagues.
How are you, sir?
Good, sir.
The president's mission here is to trumpet his administration's readiness for hurricane season.
Our top priority is ensuring the public's safety.
At the same time, back at the White House, Press Secretary Gibbs is preparing to face more reporters.
The hurricane season starts...
Gibbs hopes to use the daily briefing to reinforce the two messages of the day, cybersecurity and hurricane preparedness.
You guys gonna let me go to the bathroom again?
Are you gonna shave?
No, I'm not gonna shave. I'm gonna comb my hair. Are they ready?
Yep.
Woo!
Here we go. Gibbs starts talking about hurricanes.
Preparations that are ongoing for the upcoming hurricane season.
The president concludes his remarks on hurricanes.
Thank you very much, everybody.
But even before the motorcade returns to the White House, it's clear the media aren't exactly on board. Instead, reporters start peppering Gibbs with questions about the GM bankruptcy and Guantanamo detainees before moving on to another hot topic for this administration, a controversial comment by their Supreme Court nominee, Sonia Sotomayor.
Has the White House or anyone here had a chance to talk to her about that 2001 Berkeley speech?
The White House is about to push back. They've decided the president will do it himself, and the way he does it will become the big news of this day.